Good morning children, welcome to online class. In previous class we discussed about cyclones, rain and rivers. Okay, we have to read the homework. Are you follow the lesson? Okay, in previous class we discussed about the floodplains and floods. What is a floodplain? Floodplain means treeless bed is called the floodplain. Treeless bed is called the floodplain. Okay, next vegetation. What is meant by the vegetation? Trees, plants and grass is called the vegetation. Trees, plants and grass is called the vegetation. In this lesson we discuss about the facing the challenge in cyclones and floods. First, you have to take the textbook page number 18. See and listen very carefully. Okay, understand? Facing the challenge in cyclones and floods. What is meant by the cyclone? Cyclone is a violent tropical storm in which strong winds move in a circle. This is called a cyclone. Once again, I can repeat. What is meant by the cyclone? Cyclone is a violent tropical storm in which strong winds move in a circle. Strong winds move in a circle is called the cyclone. You know the floods. Okay, our cyclones and floods are the seasonal phenomena. Cyclones and floods are the seasonal phenomena. Once you have to see, our state has a long coast line. What is meant by the coastline? Nearer to the sea coast, that area is called the coastline. Nearer to the sea coast, that area is called the coastline. For example, in the East Bay of Bengal, nearer to this area is called the coastal areas. These are the coastal areas. In the east side, east coastal line. In the west side, west coastal line. This is the east coastal line, east coast. Okay, our state has a long coastline and is frequently faced with very destructive cyclones. That's why these places are nearer to the sea. That's why always, frequently, always faced with very destructive cyclones. When heavy winds blow from the sea, heavy rain lands and high waves. Always the waves are rising and turning on the sea. High waves make the sea very unsafe. Cyclones have a chance to occur in between June and December. When they occur, the cyclones occur in between June and December. Mostly the cyclones are occur in coastal areas June to December. One of the worst cyclonic storm in India. One of the worst cyclonic storm in India had occurred in AP in the year 1977 in the month November 14 to 20. The worst affected areas were in the Krishna Delta region. Because of this worst cyclone, the destructive areas are the Krishna Delta region. Which are the destructive areas? Krishna Delta region. You know the delta. Okay. The land of Divisima was hit by 6 meters of the high tidal waves. How many meters? It was a 6 meters high tidal waves swept across village in coastal AP, swept across the coastal AP. The land of Divisima was hit by a 6-meter high tidal, swept across villages in coastal AP. Divisima is in the region of the coastal AP. Divisima is the region of the coastal AP. Okay, this is the delta region. What is the shape of the delta? Delta is a triangular shape. Hundreds of bodies were floating on the water. Because of the village, full entire village swept across the village. Hundreds of bodies were floating on the water. Floating. Hundreds of villagers are floating on the water. About 100 people who had left their homes to seek shelter in a building, Babatla town, died when the building collapsed. When the building collapsed, hundreds of people left their shelter and collapsed, they all died. About 100 people who had left their home to seek shelter in a building, Babatla town, died when the building collapsed. Hundreds of lives are died in Babatla building because of the building was collapsed. Most lives were lost in Divisima, Krishna district in the year 2014. Most lives were lost in Divisima, Krishna district in the year 2014. Hudhud cyclone created a huge destruction in Visakhapatnam. In 2018, Tithli cyclone created huge destruction north coastal Andhra Srikakulam. Everyone knows that we are distributed some of the amount and clothes are also to this Srikakulam people. Recently in 2018, Tithli cyclone created huge destruction in north coastal Andhra Srikakulam. Once again, I can repeat, the worst affected. One of the worst, when was the worst cyclone occurred in India? In the year 1977, November 14 to November 20. Which area is affected because of the cyclone? Divisima. Where is the Divisima? In Krishna district. Where is the Krishna district? It is the coastal Andhra Pradesh. The worst affected areas were in the Krishna Delta region. The land of Divisima was hit by how many meters tidal waves? There are the 6 meters tidal waves. Next, swept across the village in coastal AP. Hundreds of, how many bodies are floating on the water? Hundreds of bodies are floating on the water. How many bodies floating on the water? Hundreds of bodies are floating on the water. About 100 people who had left their home to seek shelter in Babatla building town died when the building collapsed. Most lives were lost in Divisima in Krishna district in the year 2014. Hudhud cyclone created a huge destruction in Visakhapatnam. Recently in the year 2018, Tithli cyclone created huge destruction in north coastal Andhra Srikakulam. For example, when you see people in the vulnerable areas, vulnerable parts of the land, you will find them on the poor people. On the poor people who live there with the least resources to perfect themselves. What is meant by the slums? Where the poor people live in area is called the slum. What is meant by the slum? Where the poor people live in area. Poor people live in area is called the slum. This is the vulnerable place. Slum. Slum means what? Poor people area is called the slum. In that area, coast sea will be numerous hits. They belong to the poorest people, fisher folk. The way the poor people live, almost all the poor people are living in the coastal areas. They have to build the shelters nearer to the coastal areas. Fisher folks are also, they have to build their huts near to the coast. Because in the sea coast, there will be numerous huts. Along with the sea coast, fisher folks and the laborers and usually the land ashes of the towns and villages which see floated are occupied by the slums of the poor. Almost all these places are also occupied by the slum people. Almost all, only poor people are living nearer to the sea coast. Next, when the flood and cyclones occur, automatically the flood water will mix with the drinking water. Whenever comes the cyclones and floods, automatically the flood water mix with the drinking water, which gets polluted, and that water is drinking to unsafe for the human beings. If particularly the people contract several diseases like cholera, dysentery, jaundice, whenever they have to drink that dirty water, they may cause some of the diseases. What are the diseases? Dysentery, cholera, typhoid, jaundice, etc. Okay, then understand? Now shall I ask some of the questions? You can tell. Next, why are cyclones formed? Why are cyclones formed? The cyclones are formed in the sea due to the intense heat. The cyclones are formed in the sea. Where the cyclones are formed? The cyclones are formed in the sea. Intense of the heating up in the summer. Intense heating in the summer. In this way, cyclones are formed. What is meant by the cyclone? A cyclone is a violent tropical storm in which strong winds blow in a circle. Strong winds blow and move in a circle. This is called a cyclone. Next, normally, very good. Normally, when do the cyclones and floods occur? Normally, when do the cyclones and floods occur? In which month? The cyclones and floods are occurred in the month of the June and December. In the month of the June and December. When do cyclones form in the Bay of Bengal? When do the cyclones form in the Bay of Bengal? In the month of the May to October. In the month of the May to October. In the month of the May to October, cyclones are formed in the Bay of Bengal. In the month of the May to October, cyclones are formed in the Bay of Bengal. Where is the Bay of Bengal? In the east. In the east Bay of Bengal. The cyclones are occurred in the month of the May to October, formed in the Bay of Bengal. Which areas are affected by these cyclones? You know. Tell me the answer. In which areas are affected by these cyclones? Oh, very good. Cyclones, coastal areas are much affected by the cyclones. Coastal areas are much affected by the cyclones. Whenever occur the cyclones, only coastal areas are affected. Only coastal areas are affected. In which areas are affected by these cyclones? Coastal areas are affected much. These cyclones. Okay, now understand? Next, when do the cyclones? What is a cyclonic rain? What is a cyclonic rain? A rain caused by brilliant storm is called a cyclonic rain. A rain caused by the brilliant storm, it is called a cyclonic rain. Okay, now understand? Now I ask some of the questions to you. Okay. Why are cyclones formed? The cyclones are formed in the sea due to the intense heating up in the summer. Intense heating up in the summer. Next. Normally, when do the cyclones and floods occur? cyclones and floods are occur in the month of the June and December. When do cyclones form in the Bay of Bengal? In the month of the May to December. Cyclones are formed in the Bay of Bengal. What is a cyclonic rain? A rain is caused by a building storm is called a cyclonic rain. Next, which areas are affected by the cyclones and floods? The coastal areas are affected by cyclones. The coastal areas are affected by cyclones. Okay, next. What is the tested to areas of this cyclones? Many families may lose their working members. What is the effect of this cyclones? What is the effect of this cyclones? Many families lose their near and dearest. Many families are lose their near and dearest, and many families lose their earning members, working members. Day wage workers face loss of weeks that revolves in loss of the cyclones of decreases. Okay, understand? Next, facing the challenges in cyclones and floods. Okay, thank you.